everybody, Greg here. A quick video to do a little demonstration of a new guitar I just picked up. This is a 1967 Gibson Melody Maker SG. I'm not sure if it was called the SG or not, but this was kind of an impulse buy. It seemed like a good idea at the time, and turns out it was. So there's a lot to talk about on this guitar. The 67 Melody Makers didn't come with humbuckers. They actually came with a single bridge humbucker, or a combination of one to three single high output pickups. So, and they also came with a different bridge that had a trem on it. And from what I've seen on the internet, kind of Gibson's push at trying to compete with the growing popularity of the Stratocaster. And so it's hard to say exactly what this guitar used to look like when it was younger, but just about everything has been changed out on it that could have been. We've got the bridge was replaced with the classic style Gibson tailpiece and tune-o-matic, and then the pickups were replaced. I'm not even sure if this is the original pick guard. The pickups were replaced with a pair of 82 Tim Shaw humbuckers. I gotta say I'm not even mad, because single coils, I've got my share of single coil guitars, but old humbuckers, not as much. So this would have been a different style switch, three-way that was in it, and so that was either added. Like I said, I don't know if this one came with a single humbucker. I don't know if this one came with a single humbucker or two or three. So, but this guitar's just got a ton of mojo. I don't believe this is the original finish, but it is nitrocellulose. At least the neck is for sure, because it has that old Gibson smell to it. A friend of mine said it's like that. Smells like an old jean jacket that's been worn for years. So you'll notice with the Melody Maker, it's got the skinnier neck. It doesn't have the ears on it, and that's typical of the Melody Makers. It's got swapped out tuners that would have had Cluson tuners. Now it's got Grovers. They're not exactly perfectly lined up. The neck was reset, probably because this bridge is going to sit higher, and with it sitting that much higher than the older bridge, they needed to change the neck angle. So you can tell that the neck's been reset. I don't know if you'll be able to see that, but it's got all kinds of dings and dangs in it, but just a really cool looking and sounding guitar. And so I actually bought this guitar basically off of a couple pictures. It was a screaming deal, at least I thought it was, and I just couldn't say no. With a 67, this thing's 10 years older than I am, and it just oozes mojo. It's a Franken SG, I guess. But I didn't know what to expect, and I figured I could get rid of it if I didn't like it. But I love this guitar. It's super light, plays fast. I'm almost 100% sure. Oh yeah, for sure. If you see, you can't see on the neck here, but there's a few places where you can tell that they had replaced the frets. Just because there's some little pieces that have been glued back in, places where it had torn out a little bit when they replaced them, but that's gonna happen. It probably had almost zero frets anyway, being as old as it was. It probably had super low frets, was hard to play. But so I don't know who got rid of this guitar and who did all the modifications, but I agree. Every single one of these was a good call. Maybe not so much the gold bridge, but it's just like, it's got a tailpiece. It's got a gold tailpiece. This looks like they were gold, but they're pretty much rubbed off. This is not a Gibson tunematic bridge. This is a made in Japan bridge, so this is came from somewhere, right? It's got gold adjustment knobs. Everything else is silver, so it just the guitar makes no sense, but it plays great. It sounds amazing. And so, like I said, these are Tim Shaw. I looked at the back of them. They've got the ink stamp 1982, so PAF clones. That sound really good. And yeah, you bet. So this is, and what you were hearing is I got a just a little bit of delay. I got the reverb dimed on the Krait 5212, but it doesn't really put out a whole lot of reverb anyway. So to hear it, you basically got to dime it. I'm running through a Wampler Tumnus, so you got a little bit of delay, a little bit of reverb, the Wampler, and then I'm going through the Krait Vintage Club 5212, mic'd up with a Rode M3, and then I've also got a room mic because I just kind of wanted to see what the guitar would sound like if I room mic'd it. And so then I've got this little lapel mic for voice, but I'll mute that in between playing. But I figured I would give you some clean tones, and then maybe, I mean, I give you a little dirty in the intro there, but maybe a little bit more improv on the tail end, but some clean tones and some dirty tones, and let me know what you think. I'm digging it, so hopefully y'all agree. Okay, now we'll get some clean. And you hear the reverb and delay.